Hello everyone, my name is Moshe Naveh from the SAP community team. Today we have an SAP community call about leveraging the improved OData client of SAP Cloud SDK by Tanvi and Marco from the SAP Cloud SDK development team. Marco, please take it away.
Yeah, thanks for the introduction and welcome from my side. So let us quickly introduce yourself. So my name is Marco. I work in the SAP Cloud SDK development team, and with me is my colleague Tanvi, who also works in the Cloud SDK development team, and we both will today introduce the improved OData client with you that we have recently released. And in the beginning, I wanna share the common disclaimer with you, and especially point out that today's session does not contain any official statements about the availability of demonstrated functionality. And we are kindly asking you to make your buying and investment decisions based on what is generally available today. Thank you for that. And in the beginning, before diving into the OData client topic, I wanna spread the user survey for quarter 3, 2020 about the SAP Cloud SDK that we have made available for you. And we would like to ask you to participate. It takes about 10 minutes to take the survey. Here's the link. And we will put the link shortly also in the chat for your convenience. Of course, the survey is anonymous. And also feel free to forward the link to the survey to other members of yours who are also using the SAP Cloud SDK. In advance, we are thanking you for your participation in the survey, and we will consider your answers definitely to improve the SAP Cloud SDK in the future even more. Please be so kind and take into account to only consider the SAP Cloud SDK when answering and neglect other tools by SAP like the Cloud Application Programming Model. And even before diving into the OData client topic, I wanna share quickly with you what is new in the Cloud SDK ecosystem since the last public session. Firstly, let's quickly recap the improvements that we published in the SAP Cloud SDK for Java. So aligning with the latest release of S/4HANA Cloud 2008, we have released the corresponding virtual data model classes for the OData services. We have introduced additional OData v4 features that you can use to invoke OData v4 services. And also very prominent announcement, and that will actually be today's topic that we will dive into, that is we have released an improved OData client implementation. What that is and what are the advantages, that is what Tanvi and I will show you throughout this full presentation. And then in addition, in the realm of the JavaScript library, we have correspondingly to the Java library, we have also released the latest virtual data model classes for S/4HANA Cloud release 2008. And we have also moved the OData v4 support for the JavaScript library from the state experimental to generally available. So this is generally available since version 1.28.0. All right, after pointing out what are the latest enhancements in the whole Cloud SDK ecosystem, we will dive into the agenda for the topic of today. So I'll cover the introduction into the topic and by this also cover the recap of the current OData client. Then my colleague Tanvi will take over and introduce the new OData client to you. She will then afterwards continue with a demo on how to use the new OData client, and I'll conclude today's presentation with a conclusion. And thereafter, we will have time for your questions and try to answer them as best as possible. Then let me start with an introduction and the recap of the current OData client. So OData, Open Data, is the de facto standard for data integration with SAP solutions. And especially S/4HANA offers access to to its business data through numerous OData APIs that are described on the SAP API Business Hub. And the role of the SAP Cloud SDK is that the SAP Cloud SDK simplifies OData communication with SAP solutions through the so-called virtual data model. In short, by using the virtual data model for OData, you gain type safe and convenient access to the OData APIs in your Java code. Along with that, you receive Java abstractions for all the service operations that the API provides you. And also you have Java abstractions for the OData entities. And this is all coming out of the box by using the virtual data model of the Cloud SDK. And of course, this is also tightly integrated with the core concepts from the Cloud SDK. For example, the destinations and the tenant awareness that you get also out of the box when using the Cloud SDK. And here we depicted some example call of the current OData client that you might be familiar with. I'll not explain this in detail. We have further code snippets on the next slides. There we will examine the current client in more detail. Then I want to spend a few words on the distinction between the virtual data model and the term OData client library, because this will be important to understand the subsequent slides. So the virtual data model, I'll call that VDM in the remainder of the presentation. The VDM is built on top of a generic OData client library. The distinction is that the OData client library handles the OData communication in a generic manner. To give you one concrete example, it takes care of the payload serialization and deserialization. Opposed to that, the VDM is somehow sitting on top and it adds the OData entity and service-specific Java abstractions. So basically the VDM on top of the generic OData client library, while the client library does not know which entities and service operations in detail your API has. And currently at the time of this presentation, the VDM utilizes a third party OData client library. And this is actually where we will focus throughout the next slides. And important to know and to announce, since version 3.26.0, we have introduced a brand new improved OData client library. And in simple terms, you can adopt the new client library with only slight adjustments to your existing code base. How the adjustments look like and how easy that is, we will show you also later in the demo. Before my colleague Tanvi will touch upon the new OData client and all its specifics, I'll quickly take some time to recap the knowledge about how to use the current OData client, because later on we will compare the two. So it's important that we still remember how the current OData client is being used. So we take the prominent business partner service as example service in this presentation. So this is a code snippet how you can obtain a Java object that represents this OData API in your Java code. So the variable is called service and we have the interface type business partner service. And I'll show you now some code snippets for chosen example use cases. So here we query one entity, so one business partner by a given key, and we select only one entity field, which is the full name. And we call execute at the end. So it's a terminal operation execute, and we pass a destination as argument that represents the system against which we want to issue this OData request. And we get back a business partner abstraction of the retrieved business partner. Another example is where I query the whole entity set. In this case, I'm particularly interested in business partners where the field name country equals Germany. Yeah, so we call dot filter and then provide the field name and Germany as a string for the equals method, and we call again execute. That will be important later on that we call execute. Another example is the creation of a business partner in the backend system. So here I have a code snippet where with the builder pattern, I'm creating a business partner by hand. I could also obtain this entity with another query beforehand. Important part is that in the Basically, in the second statement, I call service.createBusinessPartner. I'm passing the business partner object as argument. I invoke again execute on a destination, and I'll get back a Java object that represents the business partner that was just created in the backend system. And last example covering the current OData client is a bit more complex one that also illustrates some of the features of the current client. Like this method here, caching metadata that enables the caching of the metadata document that we don't call for the data metadata every time. The with error handler that allows me to specify my custom error handler to influence how the exceptions look like, and so on. And again, we're calling execute. Once we have now seen how the current OData client is used in Java, let me quickly take the time to collect what are actually the drawbacks of the current OData client and where we see some potential for further improvement. First of all, the current OData client uses a third-party dependency that is out of control from the SAP Cloud SDK team. The consequence is that we cannot provide new features or improvements, and we can only hardly ship fast bug fixes. Furthermore, the current OData client is tightly coupled to OData version 2, or also called V2. And in addition, it has only a low reusability for newer OData version 4, also called V4. Moreover, as you saw in the previous slide, the current OData client and its third-party dependency, it issues an unnecessary metadata call to the backend. Thereby, it impacts performance, and that's also why it provides the feature to cache the metadata in order to improve performance. And it only allows for coarse-grained exception handling. So there is no way to distinguish specific error root causes by different exception types. And also to let you know, we plan to deprecate the current OData client in future versions of the SAP Cloud SDK. All right, that was it so far from my side. Then, Tanvi, I want to hand over to you, and you're going to introduce the new OData client to the audience.
Yeah. Hello, everyone, and thank you, Marco. I'm Tanvi. I also work in SAP Cloud SDK team, and I will introduce you with the new OData client. The new OData client has been entirely built by the SDK team. So that means it has been built entirely in-house, and it is built from scratch. It also does not rely on any other OData client library. And it overcomes all the drawbacks that my colleague Marco has just mentioned. And lastly, it is very easy to adopt the new client library in your existing code base. And with the following slides, I would like to show you how this new OData client looks like and how you can adopt your current code base on the current client to the new OData client. So the service representation object looks the same for both the clients. There's no difference in that. And to better understand how the new client looks like, I will consider some use cases. So the first use case would be to create a request for an entity by a given key. So in the slide here, you can see two requests. On the right side, the request belong to current client, and the left-hand side, the request belongs to the new client. And in these particular requests, we are requesting business partner service to get a particular business partner. The key is my partner. And the only difference that you can see in these two requests is the use of this execute method. So what does this mean is basically this execute method on the current client client makes under the hood call to the third-party dependency that we currently use. And then that client handles and executes the corresponding query. But if we replace this execute method with execute request method, then this execute request method would in turn, you will use the new client introduced by the SAP Cloud SDK team. And then this client would handle and execute the corresponding query. And yeah, that's all. So you can see it's very easy to adapt to the new client. So let's take a look and look to, in some other use cases as well. So in the next use case, we are fetching entities based on some filter condition. So this is how the requests look like. So here again, we are querying the business partner service and we have put a filter operation on that based on one of its property, which is set to Germany. And again, here as well, you can see that we can build the same queries very easily with the new client. The only thing that we have to change is, again, that's just the execute method. Now let's look at another use case, which is to create a new entity in the backend system. So to create a new entity, we may have to build the entity before we pass that entity object to the create request. So here in this case, the business partner is the entity object that we are building, and then we are passing it to the create request. You can see again, there's no difference in building the business partner entity object. And of course, the one difference is again, the execute request method. And other than that, the difference is the return type. So in the current client, the return type is an entity class business partner. But with the new client, we provide a new return type, which is modification response. And this class has many advantages. It offers many capabilities where you can access the requested entity. You can also access the response entity. So in case the OData service has responded with an entity, then we have a API for that where you can make a call to this in this class and you can fetch the response entity. And also in case of update operation, by making call to get modified entity method on this object, you get the modified entity. Lastly, let's look at how error handling is done in both the clients. Again, the right-hand side of the slide is for the current client and the left is for the new client. And so for the current client, you see we have, it only provides one exception, which is audit exception, which is a checked exception. But now the new client provides exceptions that are unchecked. And thereby new client is now kind of following the industry pattern and favoring unchecked exceptions. Other than that, the new client provides a hierarchy of exceptions. And what does that mean is then, because we have a hierarchy of exception, we provide different types of exception, now you can do a fine grain error handling. Based on what type of error you can handle, you can catch, you can use the exception and then you can handle the error as well. In the next slide, I will show what all different types of exceptions we provide in the new client. So these are the different types of exceptions. At the top level, the OData exception is a generic exception, which can be used in any scenario. And then, for example, we have OData serialization exception, which you may use to catch errors in case of serialization. Same, we have OData request exception to catch some generic error on the OData request. And yeah, we have OData response exception and so on. And lastly, let's look at all the advantages of this new improved OData client. One of the main advantage of this new OData client is that it shares code base with OData v4 module. And so what does that mean is that we make use of the same client to execute OData v4 queries as well, which then enables us for faster development and which makes Cloud SDK team helps us to have to provide faster bug fixes as well. Also, its generic implementation allows faster development for both OData v2 and v4. And as Michael mentioned, that in the current client, we make an implicit request for metadata retrieval. But in this new client, we don't do that anymore. So thereby, there is an increase in performance with this new client. Lastly, it provides a fine-grained exception handling. So with that, let's move to the demo. So in the demo, I would show you how you can transform your current code on the current client to the new client. And for that, I have prepared a test class, which has integration tests for an actual S/4HANA system. And it's making calls to a business partner service on that system. So again, I will consider certain use cases to demonstrate how you can transform your code. So let's look at the first test here. Read all business partner test. So in this test, we are reading all the business partners from S/4HANA, and we are just querying top 5 of them. And then the assertion on this test is, I'm checking if I'm getting 5 business partners in the end. So let's see if this test runs. And this test right now is on the current client. You can see that we have execute method, which is on the current client, which is the current client. And yes, so this test works, and you can see all the business partners. Now to move it to the new client, the only thing that needs to be done is just change this method here to execute request. And you see that one thing, that now we don't need this OData exception anymore, because that this is the part of the old client, and so we don't need it anymore with the new implementation. And let's see if the test runs, still runs. And screen. Mm-hmm. And yeah, so this, it still works. Now let's move into a bit more complex use case. The use case that I'm considering here is to update a business partner. And for that, I'm first fetching a business partner by key. So I know already that we have a business partner in the database with the key, with the specified key. And I'm fetching two of its properties, first name and last name. And then I have an assert statement on this request to check if I'm getting the correct business partner. So I'm asserting it on its ID again. And then once I've fetched the business partner, I do some operations to update its properties. So here I'm updating the first name and to John, and then last name. And then finally, with this updated business partner object, we can make create an update partner business partner request. And here I'm doing that. So I'm providing the object to this query, and then I'm asserting on the status code. In case of update, the OData responds with no content. So this entire code is currently on the current client, because you will see that we have the execute method. So let's run this and see if it is working. And yes, it is green. And the fetched business partner field before updating is empty. With the update operation, you don't get the updated entity with the same in the same request. So that's why we don't have the updated business partner here. But now let's change this code to the new client. So for that, For the read by key, again, you just have to change the execute method to execute request, and that's it. And for the update, you have to again change the execute method to execute request, but then because the return type is different, it expects a different return type. So let's do that. So let's delete this older line, and yeah, that's it. So you just have to call execute request and then change the return type. One thing that I forgot to mention, that this return type is used for the create operation, also for the delete operation, also for the update operation. So let's fix the assertion, because on this return type, we don't have the same method. So this is the method. And one more, now I would like to show you the capability of this return type. So for that, let's fetch the modified entity, then how the entity would look like after update would occur. So yeah, so for that, I'll use the response object, and then I would say get modified entity. And then let's uncomment this and let's run this test. And yeah, it's green. So this is the modified entity. We are getting a warning because OData web service, it doesn't give the updated entity in the same request. Yeah, that's it. So you can see that it's very easy to adopt to the new client. You just have to change the execute request, and then you have to do some modifications to adjust that. That's it from my side. That's it from the demo. And now I would like to hand over to Marco again for the final part of the presentation.
All right. Thank you, Tanvi. Then I'm going to share my screen again. Give me a second. Mm-hmm. I will stop your screen sharing and I'll continue sharing my screen. Hope you can see it. So far, we have touched the current OData client. Tanvi has introduced the new OData client. In the demo, we showed you examples how you could adjust existing code to use the new client. And I'll conclude that presentation with a summary and a conclusion before we can start looking into your questions. Let me first finish screen sharing. Now you should be able to see it. All right. So first and foremost, SAP Cloud SDK has released a new improved OData client library that is announced also with this presentation. And as we saw demonstrated by Tanvi, the new library can be easily adopted within an existing code base. And we are definitely inviting you to try out the new library. Here, the link that is posted here on this slide shows you the official documentation, where we have also outlined the adjustment guide, a few steps that you can take to adjust your existing code base. Also to tell you what kind of features are supported with the new OData client library as of today. That is at first reading entities by keys, reading all entities from the whole entity set. Furthermore, transactional requests like creating, updating and deleting entities. In addition, you can also submit batch requests with the new OData client, and we allow to count entities from a given selection. Today, not yet supported, but of course on our agenda for the future are function imports of OData. Finalizing this presentation, I want to again repeat reminding you to take part in the user survey that we have made available for you. And again, the link is on the slide and also in the chat for your convenience. And of course, also when you are eager to learn about the SAP Cloud SDK, is again a useful overview of all the learning resources that we have with the Open SAP course that is linked here. You have multiple tutorials in our tutorials navigator here. You have the link to our Cloud SDK documentation here, where you also will find the new OData client library documentation and this adjustment guide. We have also linked numerous blogs in the SAP community and also an overview blog post that summarizes all blog posts that we have published there. Always look for the tag SAP Cloud SDK. And when you want to reach out, you have the email address mentioned here. And yeah. Then Tanvi and I thank you for your attendance, for your interest in our presentation. And with that, I would say we have finished the presentation for today, and then we are opening questions and answers. So thank you again.
We have two questions in the Q&A tab, if you can access them.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let me go over them. Give me a second. So first, modification response class introduction and fine-grained exception are really cool features. Thank you for that. Then we invite you to try it out. If you have questions about it, approach us through the mentioned channels, or if you have ideas for further improvements. Secondly, just to read out the question, how does the VDM, how does the VDM differ from the REST-based data model delivered by master data integration service in SCP? Let me quickly think about that point. So the REST-based data model delivered by master data integration service. So the VDM that we presented here is so far in the first place targeting OData APIs. In that sense, they would differ in very simple terms. The one is the master integration data model is in first place REST-based. Our VDM targets OData APIs. On the programming experience level, I must admit, I'm not an expert with the master data integration REST-based data model, not in detail, but I can anticipate that it also then on a programmatic level seems to provide you also the type safe inconvenience that you just would want to expect from a nice client library. Are there more questions?
You can use either the chat or the Q&A interface. And if you would like to speak up and ask a question, you can use the raise hand feature you have in the UI. Okay, so, let's see, we have, okay, so I think we've answered all the open questions. Marco, do you wanna close off the call?
Yeah, from our side, that would it be.
Okay, cool, thank you very much. So for this great presentation and for all of you to attend. The recording will be available in the SAP community calls page. Thank you very much and see you in the next SAP community call. Bye-bye.